One day you use something as a means to an end. At that moment, you make it a thing and you depersonalize it. The fact is that the Negro was a slave in this country for 244 years. That act, that was a willful thing that was done. The Negro was brought here in chains, treated in very inhuman fashion. And
they'll be the best of whatever you are. You must have, as a basic principle, the determination to achieve
no man, no weapons formed against, yes, glorious destiny.
Every day, don't let anybody take your manhood.
Become blessings. The movement is a rhythm.
Be proud of our heritage. As somebody said earlier tonight, we don't have anything to be ashamed of.
They, although they believe differently, think different, whites can come together and discuss the common cause. But whenever a few of us come together, the world is shook up. And I say, whatever went back there is our business.
Reverend King, do you agree?
Oh, yes, yes. We had a very good
all of our daily life.
Four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream. I have a dream that one day freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and mole hill of Mississippi. From every mountainside. Let freedom ring and when we capitalize. When we allow freedom ring. When we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city. We will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours.
Hallelujah! Glory! Hallelujah!